The amount of humanitarian aid required in Clydebank after the two nights of bombing was quite astounding.
For those who had lost almost entirely everything they had owned, including their homes and perhaps livelihoods too, immediate needs could be met. Things such as food, clothing, temporary shelter, and evacuation to accommodation in other towns and cities.
Even non-essential items, such as cigarettes, were sent to Clydebank in large quantities in order to help pacify anxious and wary residents.
However, there was an altogether more pressing need. The borough council didn't have enough coffins, even those made of cardboard, let alone wooden ones, and couldn't get hold of a sufficient quantity. At first, the council was blamed for this apparent disorganisation, but the borough council was actually relatively well prepared. Time after time after time, it wrote to the powers that be in Edinburgh, asking to be provided with a sufficient stockpile of coffins, only for the request to be turned down on each occasion. The people of Clydebank, it would seem, were not a priority for the civil servants in Scotland's capital and in London. Many of the victims had to be buried in sheets. This photo, which was taken here at Old Donauter Cemetery, shows only the end section of the mass burial site. Like the other few photos that had been passed for publication, it had been liberally cropped by the censors. With many key aspects of the relief operation falling short of what the resilient but truly punished bankies deserved, it was up to volunteers, both individuals and organisations, to step in. From schoolteachers making sandwiches to miners rescuing survivors and recovering the dead, everyone has an important part to play. One organisation, the Scottish Cooperative Wholesale Society, played a major part in providing aid to some of those affected.
One of those who answered the people's call for help was Donald Dow, JP, a director of the Scottish Cooperative Wholesale Society. On the 14th of March, Donald travelled to Clydebank by car. He offered any assistance that his society could provide. He did, of course, have difficulty getting into Clydebank because of the debris and bomb craters. He had to take a detour by Knightswood Boulevard. At that time, the society was the biggest undertaker's business in Scotland, and they had the facilities to provide coffins in large quantities, such as those needed in Clydebank. Even so, there was still a shortfall. Donald also organised the shipment of clothing and shoes from its factories at Shields Hall and elsewhere. Shields Hall was also heavily involved in wartime production, manufacturing wooden frames for the mosquito fighter. People such as Donald and organisations such as the Scottish Cooperative Wholesale Society were to be, in whatever capacity, so instrumental in helping bankies at their time of extraordinary need.